In this video, I'll show you how to build this smart navigation bar. Why am I calling this navigation bar as smart? It's because when you scroll down your page, at that time, your navigation bar will be hidden, and as soon as you scroll up, your navigation bar will reappear. Similarly, I'm making this navigation bar responsive, so in your small screen size, it works totally differently. So are you ready to add this feature to your project? Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. First of all, let's change the title. For the title, I am giving Smart Navbar, or you can call it Animate Navbar on Scroll using Vanilla JavaScript. With the help of Live Server extension, let's open this HTML file in our default browser. As you can see, this is the result, and this is the code that I have taken from the last week's video where I have shown you how to generate unique profile picture for sign-in users. So if you haven't watched that video, if you are interested, you can check out. Video's link will be given in the description below, or at top right corner in your I button you can find out. Okay, now in our index.html file within main element, let's create div with class name landing. And now for div with class name landing, which is within the main element, I want to give width of 100%. And also for the main, let's copy this whole code and paste it down there. And let's give flex direction to column. Now for the div with class name landing, let's give height of 77 vh. I'm using background shorthand property, so for the first value, let's give linear gradient color. For the angle, let's give 2 top. For the first color, before that, within the root pseudo class, let's declare our primary variable. So for the primary color variable, I'm assigning this dark blue color. Now we can give the same primary color variable as first color within that var function. And for the second color, let's give transparent. And within the same line, I want to give image. So for the source, let's give within that URL function, I want to give this bg.jbg image. So that is within our same folder. And again, within the same line, I want to give background position to top. If I give forward slash, I can give background size. For the background size, I'm giving cover. And also when you scroll, at that time, I want to give a kind of parallax effect. So for that, once again, in the same line, I'm giving background attachment to fixed. So in your browser, you can see when you scroll down, you'll get a kind of parallax effect. Similarly for the body, I want to remove that minimum height, and also we don't need this code. Okay, let's remove that. Now within the body, let's create header element. Inside that header element, let's create nav element, and I'm creating anchor tag with class name logo. For the href attribute, let's give the same root destination, and within that I'm writing coding. And also within a strong tag, let's give design, and next to that let's create another list, and also let's create different list items. So for the first list, I'm giving home. For the second, let's give services. For the third, I'm giving about, and for the fourth list, I'm giving contact. Okay, in your browser you can see. Now for the body tag, let's give the same flex direction to column. And now let's give background color. For the background color, I'm giving same primary color. Now let's style the header. For the header element, okay, before that, I think I need to change all those cards background color. So for the div with class name profile, let's uncomment this code. And for the background color, let's give this white color with transparent value. And for the text color, let's give white color. And also there isn't any gap, so let's give margin. For the top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left and right, you can give 0. So instead of this margin, you could give row gap. That would be better. Now let's style the header element. So for the header, I want to give the background image. I want to give linear gradient. So for the angle, let's give 45 degree. For the first color, I want to give navy. For the second color, magenta. And for the magenta, let's give 120%. So now let's style this nav element. So for the nav element that is within our header, let's give the height of 3.7 rem. And also let's give display flex. I want to give justify content to space around. For the align items, let's give center. Now let's copy the same code and paste it there. Now for the anchor tag with class name logo, I want to give text color to white. And also let's give the same text color for our header element. anchor tag, by default they use that blue color. So in order to prevent that, I'm giving their text color white separately, okay? And also let's give text decoration to none. Similarly, for this strong tag that is within our anchor tag with class name logo, let's give color cyan. And also for anchor tag, let's change the font size. For the font size, I'm giving 1.4 rem. And now let's style order list with list items. So for the order list that is within our nav element, let's give list style to none. And also I'm giving display flex. Let's select this code and duplicate it. Now for the list items, we don't need this code. Instead, let's give padding. For the top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left and right, let's give 1.5 rem. And once again, let's select this code and duplicate it. For the list element, when you hover, let's give cursor to pointer. And also I'm giving background color to this white color with some transparent value. So now you can see when you take your mouse near to that list elements, you can get that white background color. And also let's give border radius for that list items. So for the border radius, I'm giving 0.6 rem. Now let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. So now when you scroll down at the time, I want to give sticky navigation bar. So for that, for the header element, if I give position of sticky, along with that, it will take top, bottom, left, right, this kind of property. So for the top, I'm giving 0. So as you can see, when you scroll down your page, we are getting that sticky navigation bar. And also I want to change that default scroll bar. So for the body, let's give this pseudo element scroll bar. This property may not be supported by all versions of browser. So I'm writing -webkit -scroll bar. So for the scroll bar, let's give the width, I'm giving 0.5 rem. And also let's select this whole code and duplicate it. Now let's give the scroll bar thumb. For the scroll bar thumb, I'm giving the same width. And for the background color, let's give magenta. In your browser, you can see our custom scroll bar. And also let's give the border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 0.5 rem. So now you can see it is not responsive, but I want to make our navigation bar responsive. So for that, let's use media query. I'm writing @media. Screen, and let's give the maximum width. I'm giving maximum width of 650 pixels. So now when your screen has maximum width of 650 pixels, at that time for the header, as you can see, for the body I have used their display flex. So within our body there are two elements, that is header and the main element. So for the header and for the main, I want to change their orders, okay? So for that, for the header, let's give order of 2. And let's select this code and duplicate it. Now for the main element, let's give order of 1. So in your browser, you can see when you are in your small screen, you will get that responsive navigation bar, but you can improve this design. So when you are in your small screen, something like, you could add there a bit small text with some icons, and also you can remove that logo. Now I want to make smart navigation bar. I want to give something like, when you scroll down, I want to hide my navigation bar, and when you scroll up, at that time I want to show my navigation bar. So now within that script tag, I'm creating a constant variable navbar, and I'm assigning document.querySelector. So we are selecting the header element, this header element, and also let's give scroll event for our document. For that, I'm writing document.addEventListener. So we are listening to the scroll event, and for the second parameter, let's give listener. For our event, I'm giving arrow function. Let's create another variable, last scrolled value. So initially I'm giving 0, but later on when you scroll your page, at that time we will change that last scroll values value. Now within that arrow function, let's create another variable, new scrolled value variable. So within that new scrolled value variable, I want to assign document element. If I write dot scroll top, so now with the help of this code, I will get the number of pixels that you have scrolled down, okay? Let me show you in the console. So for that, I'm writing console.log new scroll value. So in your console, did you see that? So what if I take it to the at the top, we are getting 0. As soon as you scroll, at a time we'll store that new scroll value in our last scroll value variable. So for that, for the last scroll value, let's assign that new scroll value variable. and also I don't need that console.log, so let's remove that. As you can see, I have already selected header element and I have stored that inside our constant variable navbar. I can give CSS value something like navbar.style.transform, and I'm assigning backtick. In your keyboard, just above the tab button or next to that number one key, you can find out this symbol. So now with the help of these template literals, it is easy to deal with our string and variables that we have created. Within that backtick, I'm giving translate y, that y must be capital. Now within that translate y, let's give minus. Before listening to our scroll event, let's create constant variable. So within the curly bracket, I'm writing height. So this is what you call object destructuring. So with the help of this, you can access property and at the same time, you can declare the variable. It's just like I'm hitting two stones with one stick, so which is really cool. So I'm assigning getComputedStyle. And within that, I'm passing the same navbar. Now with the help of that getComputedStyle method, I'll be able to get all the height, width, different position of our header element. So now within that translate y, I have given the minus. So just next to that, without any space, let's write dollar parenthesis. Let's pass that height constant variable. I want to show you what kind of value we are storing within that constant variable height. So let's write console.log height. In your console, did you see that? We are getting there 59.2 pixel. So that represents the height of our header or the navigation bar. So in your browser, did you see that? When we scroll, our navigation is hidden and it wasn't that smooth. For the header, let's give the transition. For the transition duration, I want to give 0.5 second. For the timing function, I'm giving is in out. So as you can see in your browser, when you scroll, we are getting that smooth transition. But when you scroll up, I want to show it again, okay? So for that, I want to use ternary operator. You can give something like new scroll value when it is greater than last scroll value. Okay, within that condition, you can give their question mark. You can write in same line, but to make you understand, I'm writing in new line. So now when your new scroll value is greater than the last scroll value at the time, we'll hide our navigation bar with the help of that translate y, and I'm passing their negative value. Your new scroll value, if that is less than our last scroll value at the time, let's take it to the initial position. So for that, I'm giving translate y to 0, and that should be a string, okay? Once again, in your browser, if you scroll down, our navigation is hidden, and when you scroll up, our navigation bar it reappears. This is pretty cool. But I want to give something like, if you are not scrolling for 1 second or 2 second at the time, I want to hide that navigation bar. So for that, I'm using this set timeout function. So for the timeout, I'm giving 1500, that means millisecond. Now within that callback, let's duplicate all this code and take it up there. So let's remove this code, and also I don't need this code. Let's remove that. So once more in your browser, when you are scrolling, okay, there is problem. When you are scrolling up, our navigation bar, it is reappearing, and at the same time, because of that set timeout function that we have gave, it is trying to hide our navigation bar. So because of that, we are getting that kind of weird effect. In order to prevent that, I want to create a timer variable, and initially I want to assign null value. And as soon as you scroll, I want to store that set timeout function within our timer variable. So now what you can do is that as soon as you scroll your page, I want to clear that timer variable. Within that clear timeout function, I can pass that timer variable. Once more in your browser, did you see that? When you scroll down, we are hiding our navigation bar. When you scroll up, you can see our navigation bar it reappears, and after 1 second, our navigation bar once again it disappears. But now you can see when you take your mouse near to that navigation bar, our navigation bar still it is hidden. So for that, in our style.css file for the header, when you hover, okay, at the time I want to give transform translate y. For the translate y, I want to give 0, but in your JavaScript code you can see I have given their transform. I want to show you in the browser as well. You can see for the header element we have given their inline CSS and we have given their transform. So because of that, if you talk about the hierarchy or the priority, our inline CSS will be given more priority than our external CSS. So now with the help of that exclamatory sign important, this code will be given much more priority. Once again, in your browser, if you take your mouse near to that navigation bar, you can see navigation bar is visible. And when you take outside, okay, that navigation bar is hidden. And once again, as soon as you scroll your page up, at the time you'll be able to see that navigation bar. But as you can see, when you scroll up it, down, our navigation bar is hidden, but the space that is occupied by our navigation bar, that is still visible. So in order to prevent that, I'm giving if condition. So within that if condition, let's give new scroll value. If that new scroll value is greater or equal to height, so this height that represents the height of our navigation bar, and that was the string, okay, that was something like 59.2 pixel. So in order to get rid of that last two characters, I'm writing dot substr. So with the help of this method, for the first parameter it will take the starting position of our string, so for that I'm giving 0. For the second parameter it will take the length of character that I want to extract, so for the second parameter I'm writing height dot length. With the help of this code, I'll be able to get the total number of the character, and if I subtract with 2, then finally now I'll be able to get only the numbers. So our condition is that when our new scroll value, if that value is greater or equal to height, okay, that is the height of our navigation bar, if that condition is true, at that time let's like call this code and let's take it up there. But if you have noticed that our navigation bar, it is responsive, so because of that, when you are in a small screen size, that navigation bar, it reacts totally different. So in install.css file, you can see we have used their media query and we have given their maximum width of 650 pixel. So let's copy all this code, and now we need to check screen size with the help of JavaScript code as well. Okay, so for that, once again, I'm giving if condition. So within that, I'm writing window.matchMedia, and within that method, you can give single quote or double quote. Within that small bracket, let's paste the code that we have copied, and along with that, I can write .matches. So with the help of this property, it will help you to return boolean value if our screen size less than or equal to 650 pixel at that time. Again, I have to write whole this code. So instead of writing separately the same code for our small screen size, it is better to create a separate function. I'm giving function update navbar position. As you can see, we haven't created that function, so let's create that function update navigation bar position, and within that function, let's bring whole this code there. As you can see, for the translate y, we have given the negative height. So now within that object navigation bar position function, I need to pass the parameter that is the height. Now we can remove that minus from our translate y. If our screen size is greater than 650 pixel at that time, let's duplicate the same code, and within that object navigation bar position, I'm giving their string minus. And let's concatenate with that height. So now when we are in bigger screen size at that time, along with that update navigation bar's position, we are passing negative height of our navigation bar. But as you can see, within that update navigation bar position function, I need to pass the parameter that is the height. I think it is better to give the position, that makes more sense. Okay, let's change all that height to position. Okay, it's not compulsory, but yeah, it makes more sense, so I'm giving the position. So once again, in our browser, if you scroll, you can see when you are in the small screen size, our navigation bar, it is at the bottom, and as you can see, for the header I have given the position of sticky, and for the top I have given the 0. So that was for the big screen size, but when you are in the small screen size at that time, for the header, let's keep bottom to 0. So once again, in your browser, you can see in your small screen size, when you scroll down, you won't be able to see navigation bar, but when you scroll up, you will be able to see our navigation bar. And also, I want to give you some bonus tips. If you want to include that scroll bar's width with our body's width in your style.css file, for the body, if you give overflow to overlay in your browser, did you see that? The width of our scroll bar, that will be included within our body's width. Okay, so now you can see everything is working perfectly fine. And also, now you can change the duration of your navigation bar that you want to show and hide. In order to do that, you can change the set timeout value. So now instead of that 1500, you can give 1000, or you can give 2000, 3000, and with changing that value, you'll be able to control the duration of time that you want to show and hide your navigation bar. So you can see everything is working perfectly. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.